In this video, we will go over the following sections. First of all, we will discuss the differences between Cluster Autoscaler, Karpenter, and AWS Fargate. Then we will create AWS VPC using Terraform. Right after that, I'll show you how to create EKS cluster and a default node group with Terraform as well. To grant access to Karpenter to create Kubernetes nodes, we would need to create OpenID Connect provider and IAM role. Then we will deploy Karpenter to EKS using Helm. To create EC2 instances, Karpenter needs a custom resource called Provisioner. Finally, we will test how quickly Karpenter can create Kubernetes nodes and schedule new pods in the cluster. Source code and all the commands are available on my website and GitHub repository. You can also find the timestamps for each section in video description. When you create a regular Kubernetes cluster in AWS, each node group will be managed by the AWS Autoscaling group. Cluster Autoscaler will adjust the desired size based on the load in your cluster to fit all the unschedulable pods. Karpenter, on the other hand, creates Kubernetes nodes directly from EC2 instances. It improves the efficiency and cost of running workloads on that cluster. Finally, AWS Fargate creates a dedicated node for each pod running in the cluster. With Fargate, you don't need to worry about infrastructure management and focus only on your workloads. First of all, we need to create VPC using Terraform. In this video, I'm not going to go over each configuration parameter of each Terraform resource as I did in the previous videos. If you'd like, you can find more details in this video. In a new version of Terraform, you have the log file with all provider versions that I use. If you face any errors during the tutorial, copy this file and rerun the Terraform. Next is the provider with some variables such as EKS cluster name and a region. VPC resource with EFS specific parameters. Internet gateway. 4 subnets, 2 private and 2 public, NAT gateway. Finally, 2 routes, 1 public with default route to the internet gateway and a private with default route to NAT gateway. Let's initialize Terraform and create all those components with Terraform apply. Next, we need to create EKS cluster and a node group. EKS requires IAM role to access AWS API on your behalf to create resources. There is a single IAM policy that needs to be attached to that role. Amazon EKS cluster policy. Then the EKS cluster itself. Provide a cluster name and the IRN of the role that we just created. Configure your cluster to be private or, for the demo, keep a public endpoint. Now we need to create another IAM role for Kubernetes nodes. It's going to be used by the regular node pool and not Karpenter. You have 2 options, either to use the same IAM role and create instance profile for Karpenter, or you can create a dedicated IAM role. But in this case, you would need to manually update auth config map to authorize nodes created by Karpenter with a new IAM role to join the cluster. I'll show you how to edit later on. For this video, let's use the same IAM role. We usually need to attach 3 AWS managed policies as a bare minimum. Then the EKS node group. It's going to be EKS managed node group created as AWS Autoscaling group with max, min and desired size. Your typical cluster autoscaler would adjust this value based on your load. Karpenter, on the other hand, creates EC2 instances directly without autoscaling groups. Now let's again apply the Terraform to create EKS cluster. To connect to the cluster, you need to update the Kubernetes context with this command. Then the quick check if you can reach Kubernetes. It should return the default K8s service. Right now, we have a single node. As I mentioned before, if you decide to create a separate IAM role and instance profile, you would need to edit the auth config map to add the IRN of the new role. Karpenter needs permissions to create EC2 instances in AWS. If you use a self-hosted Kubernetes cluster, for example, by using Kops, you can add additional IAM policies to the existing IAM role attached to the Kubernetes nodes. We use EKS. The best way to grant access to internal service would be with IAM roles for service accounts. First, we need to create OpenID Connect provider. With Terraform, it's very easy. Get the certificate and use it in Terraform resource. Next is a trust policy to allow the Kubernetes service account to assume the IAM role. Make sure that you deploy Karpenter to the Karpenter namespace with the same service account name. Then create Karpenter controller role and attach that policy. Next is a set of permissions that we need to grant to Karpenter to manage Kubernetes nodes. We will create this JSON file later, then attach it to the role as well. Since we will be using the same IAM role, we need to create IAM instance profile that Karpenter will use to attach to EC2 instances. Let's create controller trust policy.json file. You can find example in the official Karpenter GitHub project. Alright, since we've added additional provider, we need to initialize before we can apply the Terraform code. To deploy Karpenter to our cluster, we're going to use Helm. First of all, you need to authenticate with EKS using Helm provider, then the Helm release. At this time, this is the latest version of the Helm chart. There are a few important variables that we need to override. First is the annotation for the Kubernetes service account, then the EKS cluster name. Most of these variables you can pull dynamically from the Terraform resources. We also need a cluster endpoint. Karpenter will use it to join new nodes to EKS. The final variable is the instance profile. Let's apply and check if the controller is running. Check if the Helm was deployed successfully. Then the Karpenter pod in its dedicated namespace. Before we can test Karpenter, we need to create provisioner. Karpenter defines a custom resource called a provisioner to specify provisioning configuration. Each provisioner manages a distinct set of nodes. I included some parameters, such as TTL. Also, you can define the limit on how many nodes Karpenter can create. It's measured in CPU cores. You can define what types of EC2 family you want to use and exclude. Also, we need to create another custom resource, AWS node template. Here, you need to use AWS tags to select subnets and security groups. You need to replace demo with your EKS cluster name. Finally, use kubectl to create those resources in the cluster. Lastly, let's create Kubernetes deployment to test how quickly Karpenter can create EC2 instances and schedule new pods. It's going to be a simple Nginx-based deployment with 5 replicas. With given resources, this deployment won't fit on the default node group. When you're just getting started with Karpenter, it's a good idea to check logs in case you get any errors. In another window, let's run get pods. Then let's get all the nodes available in Kubernetes cluster. Finally, create deployment with 5 replicas. In a few seconds, you'll see Karpenter creates a node. In a couple of minutes, when the node transition to the ready state, all the pods will be scheduled. Karpenter is a nice tool to have in your toolbox. If I can't use AWS Fargate, I would definitely prefer Karpenter over the traditional cluster Autoscaler.